Good morning, students. Today we will continue the application of derivatives. In this we are going to discuss about the tangents and normals. Okay, in our earlier classes in the first BSc section we have learned the slope of a straight line. What is the slope or gradient of a straight line? If a straight line makes an angle theta, if you for example consider this, if a straight line makes an angle theta with the positive direction of x axis, okay, positive direction of x axis, then tan theta is called its slope or gradient of a straight line. Okay, so that is m is equal to tan theta, that is tangent. Tan theta is the tangent of the line. Okay, if a straight line makes an angle theta with the positive direction of x axis, then this one is called tangent or gradient of the line. So it is usually denoted by m is equal to tan theta, that is dy by dx is equal to tan theta. Okay, so what is the pictorial representation of this tangents and the normals? Okay, you write this one. The normal line, this one is the tangent line. Okay, this is the tangent, no? This is the tangent line. So this one is the normal line. Correct as this one as A, okay? Normal line at A, and this one is the tangent line. Tangent line at A. So y is equals to f of x. Okay, this is the pictorial representation of tangent and normal to the curve. Okay, so this is the straight line. So makes an angle theta. If the this one theta is towards anti-clockwise direction, then it is called positive angle. No, so towards positive direction of x-axis, then m is equals to tan theta is called its slope. So this is the pictorial representation of this normal and tangent line at A. So here y is equal to f of x is a, where it is a function. Okay, so based on this we have learnt in our earlier classes slope, what is the slope formula? F is equal to dy by dx. So it is dy by dx at the point x1, y1. Okay, the first one means the slope of the tangent. You should learn all the formulas, then only we can solve the problems. Okay, the first one is slope of tangent. What is slope of tangent? M is equals to dy by dx. Okay, so at the point x1, y1, m is equals to dy by dx at the point x1, y1. Next one, equation of the tangent. Equation of the tangent is y minus y1 is equals to m of x minus x1, where m is equals to, m is slope, no, dy by dx at the point x1, y1. Okay, this is m. So equation of the tangent is equals to y minus y1 is equals to m of x minus x1. X1 and y1 is the vertices, okay, it is the point where m is equal to dy by dx is slope. M is the slope at the point x1, y1. Similarly, slope of the normal, we have to find out. Slope of normal. It is equals to, it is also m. Yeah, this is slope of the normal, where it is minus 1 divided by m. Where n is nothing but dy by dx at the point x1, y1. Similarly, what is the next formula? Slope of the, this normal, this equation of the normal, equation of the normal is y minus y1 is equal to minus 1 by m of x minus. So these four formulas you have to remember, okay? If the lines are parallel, then M1 is equals to M2, and if the lines are perpendicular, M1, M2 is equals to minus 1. That is the condition for parallel and perpendicularity of the lines, okay? So that is M1 is equals to M2. If it is the parallel, if the lines are perpendicular, you can write M1, M2 is equals to minus 1, okay? So these are the formulas you have to just remember to solve this equation of the tangent and the slope of the tangent, or slope of the normal, or equation of the normal. What is the slope formula? That is M is equals to dy by dx. That is M is equals to tan theta or something, right? There are three methods of finding the slope, no? In our earlier classes we have learned M is equals to tan theta if the value of theta is given, and by using this equation of the line we can write M is equals to minus v by a, and this one M is equals to dy by dx, okay? We have to differentiate that. After that you have to substitute the value of x1, y1, and we have to differentiate dy by dx. After that we have to substitute x1 and y1 value, okay? That is the slope. We are using this one. M is equals to dy by dx. That is the slope of the tangent. The equation of the tangent is y minus y1 is equals to m of x minus x1. x1, y1 is the vertices. These are the points. And this m is the slope, that is dy by dx at x1, y1. Similarly, slope of the normal is minus 1 divided by m, where m is dy by dx at the point x1, y1. Similarly, equation of the normal is y minus y1 is equals to minus 1 divided by m of x minus x1. So, these are the four formulas you have to remember. After that, if the lines are parallel, then you have to use m1 is equals to m2. You have to equate. We have to get the same value, m1 and r, both the slope should be same. If the two lines are perpendicular, that is equals to m1 into m2 is equals to minus m, that is the condition for perpendicularity of the lines, okay? So, based on this slope of the tangent, equation of the tangent, and the slope of the normal, equation of the normal, condition for perpendicularity, we are going to solve the problems, okay? So it is in these are all concepts in application of derivatives. We have done the first one is which one? Application of derivatives, a derivative is a rate measure, that the derivative has a quantities, and the second one in the previous class, increasing and decreasing function, and this one is the third one is tangents and normals, okay? Little important is this one. Find the slope of the tangent to the curve. Find the slope of the tangent. Tangent to the curve. Y is equals to x minus 1 divided by x plus 2. X should not be equals to 2 at x is equals to 10. So this is very, very important problem which already came in the examination. So you have to be very careful. Okay? So find the slope of the tangent to the curve y is equals to x minus 1 divided by x plus 2. What is the slope of the tangent? That is, we have to differentiate. Now m is equals to dy by dx. How are you going to differentiate this one? By using which formula you are going to differentiate this one? If it is both numerator and denominator, f of x divided by g of x, derivative of f of x divided by g of x, we have to use the quotient rule, no? What is the quotient rule? So denominator, d by dx of uv, when u is equals to f of x and v is equals to g of x. In terms of numerator, this is numerator, no? upper form is numerator and this one is the denominator. So you have to use the quotient rule denominator, differentiation of numerator minus numerator, differentiation of denominator, all divided by denominator whole square. This one is called quotient rule. Okay. The product rule we have used so many times, known here also in this one. If it is both in terms of numerator and denominator, we have to use the quotient rule. Okay, so for us, this one is numerator and this one is the denominator. So we have to differentiate this with respect to x. Okay, so dy by dx, d by dx of for us, dy by dx is equal to which is denominator, x plus 2 is the denominator. We have to differentiate the numerator. We have to keep as it is the denominator and differentiate the numerator. So numerator is here. What is the differentiation of x minus 1? Differentiation of x is 1 minus, because minus is there. Differentiation of 1 is 0. Why it is 0? So because the differentiation of 1 is a constant, no? It is a constant. Differentiation of any constant is 0. Differentiation of this x is equals to 1. We have learned so many times we are using this. We used to know how this differentiation of x, you have to remember, okay? By using d by dx of x raised to n, which is equals to n x raised to n minus 1. By using that, you will get differentiation of x is 1, okay? The differentiation of x is 1 minus differentiation of 1 is 0. Okay? This we keep as it is. And this one we have differentiated. Minus, what is numerator value? X minus 1 value. So differentiation of denominator. So similarly, the differentiation of x is 1 plus the differentiation of 2 is 0. Because differentiation of any constant is 0 divided by denominator whole square. X plus 2 whole square. So this is the differentiation by using the quotient rule. Okay. So after this we have to simplify. So here 1 minus 0 is 1. So 1 will be x plus 2 is x plus 2 only. Okay. This one you have to be careful. Here also 1 you will get. 1 into x minus 1 is x minus 1. After that you have to multiply by minus, which is equals to minus x. This minus into x is minus x. Minus into minus x plus 1. So divided by x plus 2 whole square. Okay. So it is going to be like this, okay? So similarly, if the denominator is x minus 2, we come, what you are going to do for this one? If the denominator is x minus 2, okay? So how it is going to be? So you change this as x minus 2, denominator is x minus 2, okay? Denominator is x minus 2, and differentiation of numerator is 1 minus 0, minus x minus 2, this denominator differentiation, okay? So denominator we keep as it is, differentiation of numerator is 1 minus 0, minus numerator we keep as it is, differentiation of denominator is 1 minus 0, okay? Differentiation of x is 1 minus differentiation of 2 is 0, okay? What will happen after this, okay? So which is equals to x minus 2, x minus 2 into 1 is x minus 2 minus, you multiply 1 into x minus 1 is x minus 1 itself, minus x, minus x, minus into minus plus 1, okay? So which is equals to here denominator whole square, because you are changing this denominator as x minus 2, x minus 2 whole square, which is equals to x minus 2, this minus x plus 1 divided by x minus 2 whole square, which is equals to this minus x plus x is going to cancel, minus 2 plus 1 is minus 1 divided by x minus 2 whole square. So if x is not equals to 2 and x is equals to t, x is equals to 10, you get minus 1 divided by 10 minus 2 whole square. So which is equals to minus 1 divided by 10 minus 2 is 8, no? 8 squared is equals to 64. Therefore, divide by dx is equals to minus 1 divided by 64, okay? So, and this is what finding the slope of the tangent to the curve, okay? Slope of the tangent to the curve. So, consider this as x minus 1 here as numerator and x minus 2 as the denominator. So, use a quotient rule. This denominator, differentiation of numerator minus numerator into differentiation of denominator divided by denominator whole square. So denominator x minus 2, differentiation of numerator is 1 minus 0 because differentiation of x is 1, differentiation of 1 is 0, minus numerator as it is, differentiation of denominator is 1 minus 0 divided by denominator whole square. So 1 into x minus 2 is x minus 2. This one 1 minus 0 is 1. 1 into x minus 1 is x minus 1. You have to multiply this minus, which is equals to minus x plus 1. Okay, minus x plus 1 divided by x minus 2 whole square. So after this x and minus x will get cancelled, minus 2 and plus 1 is there. Minus 2 plus 1 is minus 1, this denominator. So substitute x is equals to 10, you will get 8 squared, which is equals to 64. In the numerator, minus 1 is there, minus 1 divided by 64 is the answer. Okay. So there is one important problem. So it came in the examination, okay? I'm very try to solve that one. So find the tangent at which find the tangent at which the tangent of the curve is. This is important question paper problem. Find the tangent at which the tangent to the curve, why it is equals to, you have to be very careful while writing this, 4x minus 3 minus 1, okay, has its slope, has its slope 2 divided by 3, okay. So what are they given? They are given, find the tangent at which the tangent to the curve, they are given the tangent y is equals to root 4x minus 3 minus 1. We have to differentiate that first, okay? Before differentiating that one, we'll write, first we'll write 4x minus 3, minus 1. I have told you this is root is nothing but 1 by 2. Y is equals to 4x minus 3 to the power 1 by 2 minus 1. Okay, minus 1. So we have to differentiate this with respect to x. Okay, so dy by dx is equals to 1 by 2. Okay, because d by dx of x raised to n is equals to n x n minus 1. Okay, we are using that formula 1 by 2. X is the whole thing 4x minus 3. So again n by n minus 1 is 1 by 2 minus 1. Minus 1 is there. Okay. So we have to differentiate this minus 1, it is going to be 0 because differentiation of constant is 0. Okay. So here after this we have to differentiate this because it's a this one no chain product and function of a function. We have to differentiate this. Okay, d by dx of 4x minus d by dx of 3 and after that minus d by dx of 1. We don't need to write all those things, you just understood this one, okay? Because here we got one more function here, that is function of a function, that is for child rule. So 1 by 2, this x raised to n minus 1 is 4x minus 3 to the power n minus 1 into d by dx of this 4x minus 3, that is 4x minus differentiation of this 3 and this one is there, okay? So after that you write 1 by 2, so 4x minus 3, so this one 1 by 2 minus 1. LCM, this is equals to 1 minus 2 divided by 2, which is equals to minus 1 by 2. The simplification is minus 1 by 2. So this one is differentiation of 4x is 4 and this differentiation of 3 is 0 and differentiation of 1 is 0. Okay. So you will get like this. After that you just cancel it up. 2 ones are 2 twos are. Okay. So you will get. So what you will get, remaining term dy by dx is equals to, you get 4x minus 3 to the power minus 1 by 2. What is the remaining term here? 2, okay. So it is equals to 2 into, we can write like this, okay, 4x minus 3, 1 by 2. It is coming to the, if it comes to the denominator, it is going to be a plus, okay. This also we can written as, this root 2, we have our code, this is nothing but 1 by 2. So you can write in terms of 4x minus 3, okay. Call it as equation 1. This one dy by dx is equals to equation 1. You understood this one? How we are going to do this one? You first write given the equation, given curve y is equals to square root of 4x minus 3 minus 1. So instead of 4x minus 3, this is minus 1 is there. You can write now this root can be, it is going to be, you can write like this. Because root is nothing but 1 by 2. 4x minus 3 to the power 1 by 2, you can write, okay. After that, you differentiate using this d by dx of x raised to n. That is n, that is x is 4x minus 3, n minus 1 is 1 by 2 minus 1. Again, we got one more function here, that is a function of a function which is called chain rule. So 4x you have to differentiate, 3 you have to differentiate, and minus 1 is there, you have to differentiate that also. You, this one, 1 by 2, 4x minus 3 as it is, 1 by 2 minus 1 is nothing but minus 1 by 2. Differentiation of 4x is 4. Differentiation of 3 is 0. Differentiation of 1 is 0. Because differentiation of any constant is 0. According to that, it is going to be 0. Okay. So 2 ones are 2 twos. After cancelling that, you will get 4x minus 3 to the power minus 1 by 2 into 2 is going to be. Okay. Into 2. You can write 2 into. In terms of fraction, right, in terms of numerator and denominator, it is going to be 1 by 2, 4x minus 3, 1 minus 1 by 2 is going to be plus 1 by 2. So this can be written as root 4x minus 3, okay. So 2 divided by root 4x minus 3 and you have to, and they are given the slope also. What is the slope? Slope is equals to this one, no? 2 by 3. So Pythagoras equation 2. And they given the value of also, they given m is equals to, m is nothing but dy by dx, no? M is equals to dy by dx, which is equals to 2 by 3. So equate 1 and 2. After getting this equation now, equating 1 and 2, you will get 2 divided by, this is square root of 4x minus 3, which is equals to 2 divided by 3. So you will get square root of 4x minus 3, which is equals to 3. Square, for this, you squaring on both sides. If you squaring on both sides, you will get root 4x minus 3 whole square, which is equals to 3 square. These two will get cancelled. 4x minus 3 is equals to 3, 3 is 9. So it is equals to 4x is equals to 9 plus 3. Because I am transposing this minus 3 to plus 3, okay? So 4x is equals to 12, 4 ones are 4, 3 is x is equals to 3. So we have got x is equals to this one 3. And we have to substitute this one. So this equation is going to be, therefore y is equals to square root of this what we have got this one now. This one now, and this 4x minus 3 is equals to 3. We have got 3 and minus 1 is 3, so y is equals to 3. Therefore x is equals to 3 and this y is equals to 2 we have got. So hence the required points are 3 and 2. Okay. So this is finding the root of this equation, okay? You understood this one? So what we have to do first, we have to write, and we have to take that equation, because it's important, y is equal to square root of 4x minus 3 minus 1, you differentiate that, okay? How we are going to differentiate? This root 4x minus 3 is going to be 4x minus 3 to the power of 1 by 2, okay? It is going to be like this. This 4x minus 3 to the power of 1 by 2. Minus 1 is there, you write minus 1. After that, you differentiate by using d by dx of x raised to n. So, after that, okay, after getting, you will get the point which one you will get like this now. 2 divided by root 4x minus 3 will get. After that, they are given another slope that is equals to 2 by 3, divided by dx is equals to 2 by 3. Equate both the equations, equate 1 and 2. After equating 1 and 2, you will get this terms, okay? Root 4x minus 3 is equals to 3. Squaring on both sides, after squaring on both sides, you will get only 4x minus 3. This is going to be 9. So 4x is equals to 9 plus 3, which is equals to 12. So x is equals to 3, you will get. So if you substitute, you can do like this also. It is better if you are like this only. So 4 of 1 is 3 minus 3 minus 1 y is equals to 4, 3 is 12 minus 3 minus 1 y is equals to 9 minus 1 which is equals to square root of 9 is 3 which is equals to minus 1. So y is equals to 3. Okay. And so just try to, we have just simplified this one as 3, no? So which is equals to minus 1, 3 minus 1 which is equals to 2, okay? So we have got x is equals to 3 and y is equals to 2 in this, okay? Next, this is also very, very important. Find the points on the curve. It also came in the examination. Find the points on the curve. On the curve, x square divided by 9 plus y square divided by 16. Z equals to 1, at which the tangents are parallel to x-axis, parallel to y. Find the points on the curve. x squared divided by 9 plus y squared divided by 16 is equals to 1, at which the tangents are parallel to x axis and parallel to y axis. Okay. So we have to find out the points on the curve. So this is also very, very important. First we have to differentiate this one. No? How we are going to differentiate this one? So differentiation of x squared is 2x. Here divided by 9 is a constant. You can write it as it is. Otherwise this 1 by 9 d by dx of x squared. You can write like this. 1 by 9 d by dx of x squared is 2x. Which is nothing but same. Okay? Similarly, y squared differentiation is 2y. So as divided by 16 is there. If it is y, you have to write in terms of dy by dx, which is equals to 0. This one, okay? So x squared divided by 9 plus y squared divided by 12 is y squared divided by 16 is equals to differentiation of x squared is 2x. 9 is a constant, you keep as it is. If there is a constant along with variable, you have to just keep the constant outside. No, if there is only one constant, you have to differentiate. Otherwise, we have to write along with this. Because differentiation of x squared is 2x divided by 9. Because if the constant is here along with variable, plus y squared differentiation is 2y into dy by dx divided by 16, which is equals to 0. So I try to write in terms of dy by dx. 2y divided by 16 dy by dx is equals to, this is going to be the right side, minus 2x divided by 9. So dy by dx is equals to minus 2x divided by 9 into, here, you know, see the divisor are 16 divided by 2y, okay? So this and this will get this 2 and this 2 will cancel. Minus 16x divided by 9y. So dy by dx is equals to minus 16x divided by 9y. Okay. So this is slope. We have got dy by dx is equals to minus 16x divided by 9y. This is the slope of the tangent. Okay. Slope of the tangent. Next one, what we have to find out? Parallel to x-axis. The tangent is parallel to x-axis, okay? We have to write the same things for tangent parallel to x-axis. We have dy by dx is equals to 0 like that. For tangent parallel to x-axis, we have dy by dx is equals to 0. What is we have dy by dx? When it's 16, x divided by 9y is equals to 0. Okay, we have to substitute this implies this x is equals to 0. No, we have to substitute x is equals to 0 in this equation 1. You will get to 1. What do you get? So this one, x is equals to 0 means it is going to be 0. No, 0 plus y squared divided by 16, which is equals to 1, implies y squared is equals to 16, y is equals to square root of 16, y is equals to plus or minus 4, okay? Plus or minus 4. When x is equals to 0, we have got y is equals to 4. Similarly, when x is equals to 0, we have got y is equals to minus 4. This is the tangent parallel to x axis. Therefore, the required points in the curve are x is equals to 0, y is equals to 4, x is equals to 0, y is equals to minus 4. This is the tangent parallel to x-axis. Okay. You understood this one? Okay. What we have done first here, we are taking this equation x squared divided by 9 plus y squared divided by 16 is equals to 1. So differentiation of x squared is 2x divided by 9 plus y squared differentiation is 2y divided by 16 into dy by dx. So you are writing this as it is, we are taking this to RHS. It is going to be minus 2x divided by 9. In right in terms of dy by dx is equals to this divided by this. divided by. After this, it is going to be inverse in the device. Okay, so it is going to be changed. Reciprocal is going to be. So minus 2x divided by 9 into 16 divided by 2 by 2. 2 will get cancelled, which is equal to minus 16x divided by 9 by 2. First, we have to write in terms of dy by dx. Okay, we have to differentiate that. Okay, that curve. After that, they are given. They are asked to tangent to find out the tangent at which the parallel to x axis. We have to find out the points and the curve at which the tangents are parallel to x axis. We have to find out the points on this curve for which the tangents are parallel to x axis. So parallel to x axis means this of this dy by dx is going to be 0. It means 0 means this x is going to be 0. So we have to substitute x is equal to 0 in terms here. Now we have to substitute in equation 1, x is equal to 0. You will get only this one now, y square divided by 16 is equal to 1, you will get. So y square is equal to 16, y is equal to square root of 16, y is equal to plus or minus 4. Therefore, the required points are x is equal to 0. Y is equal to plus 4, x is equal to 0, y is equal to minus 4. So therefore the points are 0, 4 and 0, minus 4 we will get. So again we have to find out, similarly we have to find out tangent at which the points are parallel to y axis. How it is going to be? So for tangent parallel to y axis we have dy by dx tends to, which is equal to infinity, okay? It is parallel to y axis means we have dy by dx is equal to 0, infinity. So we write this, okay? Second one is the second one for tangent parallel to y axis, okay? For tangent parallel to y axis we have dy by dx is equal to tends to infinity. So this we have learnt in our first year PUC, okay? So when it is going to be infinity and then when it is going to be 0. So dy by dx tends to infinity. Otherwise you can write dx by dy, okay? Dx by dy is equal to 0. So this is dy by dx, no? This is dy by dx is minus 16x divided by 9y. What is dx divided by dy? It means 9y, that is minus 9y divided by 16x. So dx by dy implies that is minus 9y divided by 16x is equal to 0. Implies y is equal to 0. It implies y is equal to 0. We have to substitute y is equal to 0 in this equation 1. We will get x squared divided by 9. This whole part is going to be 0, which is equal to 1. X squared divided by 9 is equal to 1. X square is equal to 9, because that's what we make. X is equal to square root of 9, x is equal to plus or minus 3. Therefore, the points are when x is equal to 3, y is equal to 0, and this x is equal to minus 3, y is equal to 0. Therefore, the points are x is equal to 3, 0, and y is equal to minus 3, 0. Therefore, the required points are 3, 0 and minus 3, 0. Okay. So this is also very, very important. Okay. First, you have to differentiate the curve. So what are the given? You have to try to differentiate this. You write in terms of dy by dx. Okay. After that, for which the tangent is parallel to x-axis means dy by dx is equal to 0. So dy by dx is equal to 0 means y is equal to 0. So put y is equal to 0 in this equation. Okay. So similarly, put x is equal to 0 in this equation. You get for tangent parallel to x axis and parallel to y axis. Okay. Understood this one? So first differentiate this one. Okay, this is very, very important. Differentiating of this is very important. After that, the first question is tangent is parallel to x axis. So this is equal to x axis. Minus 16x divided by 9y is equal to 0 implies x is equal to 0. Okay, so x is equal to 0 means you will get the y value. Next, we go for parallel to y axis, means dy by dx tends to infinity, or dx by dy. Okay, first dy by dx tends to infinity, or dx by dy is equal to 0. So it is going to be inverse, that is this one, minus 9y divided by 16x is equal to 0, implies y is equal to 0. Put y is equal to 0 here, you will get x value. Okay, before that we used to get here you are getting y value, here you are getting x values. Okay. So if you do like this, just try to practice the similar problems. Okay. Next. So next one, find the slope of the tangent to the curve. This one is over. Find the slope of the tangent to the curve. Find the slope of the tangent. Y is equal to x cubed minus 6. And x is equal to 2. Okay. So what is the slope for dy by dx? Okay, m is equals to dy by dx. After that, so you have to substitute the value of x1, y1 in slope. Okay, so what is the differentiation of this? Dy by dx is equals to differentiation of this dy by dx of x cube minus dy dx of x. Okay, so what is dy dx of x cube, which is equals to 3x square minus dy dx of x, that is differentiation of x is 1, differentiation of x cube is 3x square. So now dy by dx at the point, they are given at the point x is equal to 2. So it is equal to 3 of 2, 4 square minus 1, 3 of 2, 2 is 4, minus 1, which is equal to 12, minus 1, which is equal to 11. Find the slope of the tangent to the curve is equal to x cube minus x at x is equal to 2. So this is the slope of the tangent, that is equal to 3x square minus 1. Okay. After that we have to substitute this x is equal to 2. If there is y also, if there is in this equation, if you get y also, you have to substitute y value. So you have to get x is equal to 2. After substituting, you will get this slope is equal to 11. Okay. Find the slope of the tangent to the curve. Y is equals to, next question, y is equals to x cube minus 3x plus 2 at the point whose x coordinate is 3. At the point whose x coordinate is 3. Okay. So we have to differentiate this one, not dy by dx. So what is the differentiation of x cube? I have told you the shortcut method also. X cube, so 3x square. So this 3 is going to become here, and x cube is going to be x square when it is a positive integer. Okay. So x cube differentiation is 3x square minus differentiation of 3x is 3, because the differentiation of x is 1. So 1 into 3 is 3. Plus differentiation of 2 is 0. After that, dy by dx at the point which is at the view is whose x coordinate is 3, and means x value is equal to 3. So 3 of 3, 4 square minus 3. So 3, that is 9 minus 3, which is equal to 27 minus 3, which is equal to 24. Okay? So therefore, dy by dx is equal to 24. So this is the finding slope of the tangent. Okay. So similarly, we used to get equation of the tangent, equation of the this one, normal, slope of the normal, you will get like this. So what is the slope of the tangent? Dy by dx at the value of x1 y1, okay, that is so slope of the tangent. Similarly, what is the equation of the tangent? Equation of the tangent is y minus y1 is equals to m of x minus x1, where m is nothing but this one dy by dx. Now m is equals to dy by dx at x1 y1. So that is the slope of the tangent, slope of the equation of the tangent. Next one is the slope of the normal is minus 1 divided by m. Similarly, equation of the tangent is y minus y1 is equals to minus 1 divided by m of x minus x1. And here we have used this one, no? Slope also we have used, slope of the tangent, m is equals to dy by dx. After that, equation of the tangent, y minus y1 is equals to m of x minus x1, okay? So based on this, we continue solving the problems, okay? Just practice the problems until then.